Hi. Okay, so a question I get a lot is how I got started working remotely, which has enabled me to travel the world. What you will take away from this, though, are the exact tips that I used to be able to work remotely. And then hopefully you can start working remotely and building your skills, and you can progress your career or build a career online from anywhere in the world. By the way, I'm Kelly Hill. I am an online content creator, web designer, web developer, UI/UX designer. I do apps. I work remotely. I've been working remotely for the last 3 years. How I got started working remotely 3 years ago, working from my laptop anywhere, wherever in the world, whether that's on a beach, in a city, on a plane, anywhere. And I'm here to help you learn how you can do it too, how you can build a career online, how you can build a career in an industry and make an impact from anywhere in the world. So I started working remotely 3 years ago, and it's enabled me to travel to over 30 countries and just see a lot of cool places and still build a career while doing that. 3 years ago, I was living in New York City. I was working at a tech startup. I basically got into the tech world sort of by accident. After I graduated college, I married my husband and we moved to New York City. I'd always dreamed of moving to New York since I was a little girl, and it was so exciting. So I studied art in college, and I didn't realize until my final semester, oh, I will need to get a job after college. Didn't really like occur to me. I was just like really pursuing my passions. I just decided like I wanted to be really good at the things that I was passionate about, and if I focused on being really, really good, then I knew it would lead me somewhere and I would be successful with that. And so I was just determined to be really good at whatever I was doing. I moved to New York with my husband. He started working at a tech company, if you've heard of Yelp. I of course thought like, oh well, you know, I'll work in fashion. Like literally every other girl who graduates college and they're 22, and yeah, I kind of realized like I wasn't really gonna make any money doing that. It's also really hard to get into fashion too. In addition to having studied art, I started learning how to build websites when I was 13, and this wasn't just changing the font color on your MySpace. No, I was like building websites. For some reason, really wanted to create these different websites for like my pets and my friends, and I would create graphics. And not unlike now, where I have like free graphics that you can download, and oh, it's a website that I coded. I literally would code websites where you can take the graphics and I would put the code there, and you can copy and paste the code and put it on like your MySpace. This really makes me sound so old. But I taught myself how to do all of that, and I just didn't realize that building websites was a job. I didn't realize that it was a job people pay you for. I didn't realize you can make a lot of money with these skills. So when I moved to New York, I got connected with a friend of my husband's, and he was working at a tech company, a tech startup, and they were looking for a designer and someone who knew how to do websites. And so I got looped in that, and that was kind of like my first into the tech world. And then from there, I just got into the tech world and the startup world, and really it moved super quickly. I got promoted pretty quickly. Suddenly I was managing design team at a very young age. And just, I think the tech world and especially startup world, you move super, super quickly. So I was really building like a lot of skills. And from doing that, I got into UI UX design and app development. So I started out with these design skills from my art school. Even though I concentrated in painting, I had a foundation of design skills as well from classes and then also on my own. But your portfolio is all that matters, especially in design, especially in development. Your work examples are all that matters. I certainly got lucky with having the BFA. It was like the right degree to have if you want to be designed. And then I think also working at a startup, you have to wear so many different hats. So it was really easy for me to just like slide into other roles. I got hired as a designer, but then suddenly I was managing the website, and suddenly I was leading the development of that. Suddenly I was developing it as well, working with other developers, bringing on developers to work with as a team, bringing on designers, hiring designers. So everything moved really, really quickly. So this is how my career started. Basically, after about 2 years in New York City, especially my husband, so he was working at Yelp, and then he got into tech startups as well. And he was definitely feeling a lot more of the frustration of living in the city. We grew up in a beach town. We grew up at the beach. He was surfing every day. We would have to drive out to Long Island. We would make the drive sometimes early in the morning. I know it's crazy that we even had a car in Manhattan. Like, don't do that. I do not advise that. But my husband really wanted to surf and be able to surf, and he did not want to take his surfboard on the subway. So we'd get up at 5 a.m. and drive out to the closest beach on Long Island if there was a swell coming, and he would surf before work, and we would get back into the city just in time for him to go to work. Time I was working for one tech startup that my work kind of started pretty late in the morning. We didn't have our daily stand up until 11 a.m. Make sure he got to work, and I would go repark the car and then I'd go to work. So anyways, we had always traveled. Something that we really bonded over when we were young in college, we'd go see a new country every year. And when we were starting our careers in New York City, I always had the ability, like if I wanted to go home, I'd kind of work from my laptop, and my company was fine with that. But my husband did not have that flexibility. So when we moved to New York, it's like we stopped taking trips that we used to always take. Part of it, he just didn't really have the flexibility in his position to do that. And I was getting frustrated by that point at doing that. The other thing I started to realize, because I was in the design and tech world, and UI UX is still a very new thing. People still don't know what that is unless they're in the tech world. It's user interface design, user experience design. They're two separate things, but I have been able to do both. Not everyone does both. Certainly at big companies, you're either one or the other. So at a startup, you need to be able to do both. It's a small team, you gotta be able to move very quickly. I was learning all these new skills. Startup, you have to be agile. You gotta like move quickly, you gotta learn new stuff, you gotta go with the flow. So I realized that I was learning all of these new things online. I started following different leaders in the industry, and what did I realize about some of these leaders in the industry? They were working remotely. One company, which I love this company, and I've been a customer of their products for a while now, Envision App, and they had a really great blog, and I was learning a lot from them. They were hosting events, and I would go to them, and I realized like this company that I'm learning from, that I'm someone on the ground in New York City working in tech, working in hardware, working at startups, and I'm learning from a company that is completely remote. And that totally changed my view that, wow, who I'm looking up to and learning from is a remote company. These are people who are working remotely. And it just made me realize that you don't need to be in a place to make an impact in an industry or to be a leader in an industry. Another third realization that I had was looking at the people around me that were in positions above me and realizing that's where I could go if I followed their exact steps. And I didn't really want their life. For someone that had been working in the industry for 10 more years than me, they weren't where I imagined myself to be at that point. And maybe following this path that people are telling me to follow isn't the solution. And that's another thing I've learned, is people who are telling you to follow a certain path, do you want their life? Like, think about that. Like, if someone says you need to go get this stable job and like whatever, is their life how you see yours? And if the answer is yes, then listen to them. And if the answer is no, think about why are they telling you this? And you know, so after having these realizations, my husband and I, I'd been nagging, hey, we need to book a trip. And finally we found like these really cheap flights to Morocco from New York. And this is in 2016. We found these really cheap flights. The flights were for February 2017. We only booked one way, and that was because my husband wasn't sure if he would be able to take 1 week off or 2 weeks off, and it would depend on his performance because he was in sales. And so he really wanted to be able to take 2 weeks, but he couldn't commit to taking 2 weeks until he knew closer performance was really good and like his boss would be okay with him taking 2 weeks off instead of one. So we booked the flight like six or eight months ahead of time. You know, we'd been in the city for almost 3 years. We just started joking, like, what if we just didn't come back? Like, what if we just had the one way flight? He first said that to me and I literally like freaked out. Like, I was like, oh my God, like I just couldn't handle it. Like, New York had become my safe space. The more that we joked about like, what if we just don't come back? But I kind of started realizing more about leaders in the industry. They don't have to be in one location. That wasn't dependent on their success. That was a huge learning. Your location is not dependent on your success and how quickly you can succeed and how quickly you can grow and the fact that you can grow a very successful career. We just joked and joked, and eventually a kind of turning point with the startup that I was working at, and things were getting, and startup world is rocky, and we had to make a decision, you know, what we wanted to do. And my husband was like, we should go travel for a few months. And so I told my boss, my husband's ready to leave the city and he wants to change his career. And I wasn't ready to leave my career. I wasn't ready to leave my job, but I also wanted to travel. And so that was so hard for me because I didn't want to leave New York. I didn't want to leave my career behind. I didn't want to take a break from my career. I didn't want to not have a job. But I wanted to travel too. But I went into this conversation realizing they need me. This company that I was working for, they need me because I became really valuable to them. And I know that because I really built up a lot of different skills and became an asset. And that, and part of that was just by being really good at my job, going above and beyond, you know, going the extra mile. If you want to get promoted, start doing the job of the job you want to get promoted, because it makes that decision of promotion a lot easier. Other thing I'd done is whenever I had worked from home, I never slacked. Working from home was no different than working in the office. I had a sick day or like was just like working from home during a holiday, visiting my family. I made sure that's no different. If anything, I was in touch with everyone more. The last thing done in my job is I just always try to bring a great mood to the office, and I never let outside stuff come into work, come into the office, because that really affects your working relationships and it affects the productivity of the team. And it's okay, we have things that go on in our life, but you're allowed to have a bad day. But I think in a working environment, it's really important to keep positivity there and to keep a smile on and just focus on building real relationships with your coworkers. And I had really done that over the last few years. Your performance improves when you work together well and when you focus on your relationship with your coworkers and building a good relationship, and that's open and honest. Asking them how they are doing and not always talking about work. Be a friend to them. I had done all these things in my job, and so when I went into this conversation with my boss saying, hey, we're gonna be moving out of our apartment and we're gonna be traveling for a few months, the first thing he asked me was, well, do you wanna work remotely? And I was like, of course. I went into this really hoping that that would be the outcome. I did have to mentally prepare that I would be no longer working for the company. So I had to go into it being okay with no longer having the job, but I went into it with the hope that I would be able to work remotely because I wasn't ready to leave the company, and I don't think the company was ready for me to leave either. So I was in this good position that they offered me to work remotely, and we moved out of our apartment, set off on this adventure. In January of 2017, we went to Costa Rica. We spent a month in Costa Rica. We spent a month in Panama. Made a pit stop back in New York, where I actually worked in the office for a week. Then we went over to Morocco. We spent a month in Morocco. We spent time in France and time in Spain, and then spent a month in Portugal. I'll have to do another video about why then we left Portugal and went back to the States, because that's another fun little exciting thing on our journey. But when I was working remotely, it didn't matter where I was in the world. I was working not nine to five, but like 10 to 6, because that was the office hours, East Coast time. I was on Slack every day, making sure you saw my green light. I went above and beyond. Sometimes I would video conference with my boss. We would just like have the kind of like a FaceTime where you're just independently working. So it felt like we were working in the office together, like we were side by side. So we would just like do our own work, but like be on FaceTime. We wouldn't do that like all the time, but like sometimes, just because I developed a really great relationship with my coworkers. I think that's so important to like continue that when you work remotely. Make sure to put in the extra effort to maintain your relationship. And I was always there 5 minutes early, 5 minutes later, or, you know, whatever was needed, being always available and just really making sure that my coworkers knew that I was online. Like, just because I was not in the office, they knew that if they messaged me and it was 1 p.m., they were gonna get a response. Just like if they were in the office with me, really hammering out like our communication and really putting things down on paper and being really organized definitely really helped. This is the start, and I was hooked. In Europe, I would explore all day, and then around, depending on where I was, 4 p.m., 5 p.m., once it was the workday starting on the East Coast in New York, I would log on and I would start my workday, and I just became hooked with working remotely. I felt like I was doing more than when I was in the office because I was having these full days of exploration, and then I would go and work instead of just like waking up, rolling out of bed, eating breakfast and going to the office and then coming home and having dinner and calling it a day. I was exploring, doing all this cool stuff and working. I was hooked. I was like, wow, this is awesome. And you know, we were progressing and moving forward, and we realized, wow, you can really have this career, build it with a team. I maintained my same salary job. So I wasn't just like breaking off and doing my own thing. Like, I still had my same salary that I had in New York, but from anywhere in the world. And when you go from spending $2,500 a month on your rent in New York City for one crappy old one bedroom in Manhattan downtown, to then spending $2,500 for an entire month in Costa Rica, it really puts things into perspective for you. Literally, that was just my rent in New York City, and that literally paid for everything for a whole month in Costa Rica, and I was still having my career. So it just like made sense to me. Wow, this is amazing. This is how I got started working remotely. Things look a little different now. This is 3 years ago, but this is how I got started. We'll dive into what it's like now and how this has evolved over the last 3 years in the next video. You know someone that needs to hear this story to know that it's possible to work remotely and build a career, please share this video with them. I would really love that. Ever since I started that, I'm so passionate about that this is possible, and it's not for everyone, but you know, if this is for someone that you know, please, please share it. If you wanna know more about this, please like this video and please subscribe. Also, if you want more remote work tips, I share a ton of remote work tips on my TikTok. So head to my TikTok for just little snippets of remote work. And then on my Instagram, that's where I hang out every single day, and you can see all my travels. So head over there and follow me there if you're not already. Yeah, so stay tuned.